I just like the firepower. I'm a little kid at heart. I like working on the gun. I like loading all the munitions we load. When we go TDY anywhere, like to Davis Monthan or anything like that, we load everything we can get our hands on. And it's entertaining. It's hard work, it keeps me busy, but it's fun.
Always a welcome sight to U.S. and Allied forces on the ground. This is the A-10 Thunderbolt II, better known to its legions of fans as the Warthog. While it can be equipped with a wide variety of today's most sophisticated weaponry, the Warthog is, and always will be, known for one rather distinct feature. This is the gun. Officially known as the GAU-8 Avenger, the gun is the primary weapon system upon which the entire airframe of the A-10 was built. It is essentially a flying cannon providing 30 millimeters worth of American air power.
So this is obviously the business end of the 30 millimeter. Here are the rounds right here. So this is the casing for the round. And these are actually, they stay within the gun because if you were to spit these out, like a lot of times other guns will, so much ballast and the center of gravity of the aircraft will come off so much that you have to keep it in. A normal combat burst is what we call it, is a 2 second squeeze. So with the gun spinning out, that's around 112 rounds for 2 seconds. With the amount of rounds that we have, which is 1,100, I guess about 9 trigger pulls of useful, I guess, combat damage that we can provide. The gun is by far the Hogpod's favorite thing to do. The gun is the most flexible weapon we have, most of the time the most effective, but then we also at the same time too can carry a pretty incredible assortment of different weapons between the Maverick missiles, precision guided munitions, rockets, illumination stuff we can use at night, and all different sorts of stuff they're constantly building upon in the Hog, but the gun is still the most effective, flexible weapon we have.
One of the distinctive abilities of the gun is the significant amount of firepower it can put into a target in very short order. The GAU-8 is a complex piece of heavy metal consisting of 7 rotating barrels, each 7.5 feet long, and weighing 70 pounds apiece, with the total gun assembly, including the feed system and loaded ammo drum, weighing over 4,000 pounds. Airmen working in the aircraft armament systems field are responsible for keeping the weapon system inspected, maintained, and capable of spitting out up to 70 rounds per second.
The GAU-8 system holds 1,150 rounds. It fires approximately 3,900 rounds a minute. The first second of fire fires approximately 50 rounds a second, and then from there it accelerates up to 70 rounds a second. One of the best aspects of working on this is hearing back from ground troops where they called it in and the weapon system performed as designed. It's great to be a part of that.
This is the ammunition loading adapter that we use on the 30 millimeter gun on the A-10 Thunderbolt II. It's commonly referred to as the ALA or the Dragon. The ALA is powered by the aircraft's hydraulic power through a flex drive. It attaches to the aircraft with the load head, and we have a CIU that attaches to the ammo can that's delivered by ammo. We normally load 575 rounds per can, which adds up to 1150 for the aircraft. And what it does at the same time, we can upload bullets and download bullets, and this times directly to the gun system.
One of the training advantages available to A-10s and other aircraft in the Great Lakes region is the proximity of the Grayling Air Gunnery Range in northern Michigan. A-10 pilots from the 107th Fighter Squadron at Selfridge Air National Guard Base are just a 30-minute flight to the range at Grayling, where pilots face realistic and dynamic training scenarios. There, pilots are able to train with joint terminal attack controllers, placing bombs and bullets right on target.
It's an awesome target set that we can go up there and play on. They're constantly changing it around as to what their customers' needs are. It prepares you very well because you can go up there, practice it, you know, kind of training around it. And really when you start to fly over in Afghanistan, start to do the stuff that you're practicing training for up there, you're like, oh yeah, I remember doing this up at Grayling a lot of times.
For Warthog pilots, maintainers, and their fellow airmen, ensuring this firepower is available when and where needed is at the core of their duty to their state and nation.
The thing I like the most, obviously, is serving the United States military, serving in that capacity, and helping protect the people. in America, overseas, and being a part of that. Our biggest thing that we do as hog pilots, helping out the troops on the ground and providing that aerial coverage that they could need at any time.
I just like the firepower. I'm a little kid at heart. I like working on the gun. I like loading all the munitions we load. When we go TDY anywhere, like to Davis Month or anything like that, we load everything we can get our hands on. And it's entertaining. It's hard work, it keeps me busy, but it's fun.
Always a welcome sight to US and Allied forces on the ground. This is the A-10 Thunderbolt II, better known to its legions of fans as the Warthog. While it can be equipped with a wide variety of today's most sophisticated weaponry, the Warthog is and always will be known for one rather distinct feature. This is the gun. Officially known as the GAU-8 Avenger, the gun is the primary weapon system upon which the entire airframe of the A-10 was built. It is essentially a flying cannon providing 30 millimeters worth of American air power.
So this is obviously the business end of the 30 millimeter. Here are the rounds right here. So this is the casing for the round. And these are actually, they stay within the gun because if you were to spit these out, like a lot of times other guns will, so much ballast and the center of gravity of the aircraft will come off so much that you have to keep it in. A normal combat burst is what we call it, is a 2 second squeeze. So with the gun spinning out, that's around 112 rounds for 2 seconds. With the amount of rounds that we have, which is 1,100, I guess about 9 trigger pulls of useful, I guess, combat damage that we can provide. The gun is by far the hog pilot's favorite thing to do. The gun is the most flexible weapon we have, most of the time the most effective, but then we also at the same time too can carry a pretty incredible assortment of different weapons between the Maverick missiles, precision guided munitions, rockets, illumination, stuff we can use at night, and all different sorts of stuff they're constantly building upon in the Hog, but the gun is still the most effective, flexible weapon that we have.
One of the distinctive abilities of the gun is the significant amount of firepower it can put into a target in very short order. The GAU-8 is a complex piece of heavy metal consisting of 7 rotating barrels, each 7.5 feet long and weighing 70 pounds apiece, with the total gun assembly, including the feed system and loaded ammo drum, weighing over 4,000 pounds. Airmen working in the aircraft armament systems field are responsible for keeping the weapon system inspected, maintained, and capable of spitting out up to 70 rounds per second.
The GAU-8 system holds 1,150 rounds. It fires approximately 3,900 rounds a minute. The first second of fire fires approximately 50 rounds a second, and then from there it accelerates up to 70 rounds a second. One of the best aspects of working on this is hearing back from ground troops where they called it in and the weapon system performed as designed. It's great to be a part of that.
This is the ammunition loading adapter that we use on the 30 millimeter gun on the A-10 Thunderbolt II. It's commonly referred to as the ALA or the Dragon. The ALA is powered by the aircraft's hydraulic power through a flex drive. It attaches to the aircraft with the load head, and we have a CIU that attaches to the ammo can that's delivered by ammo. We normally load 575 rounds per can, which adds up to 1150 for the aircraft. And what it does at the same time, we can upload bullets and download bullets, and this times directly to the gun system.
One of the training advantages available to A-10s and other aircraft in the Great Lakes region is the proximity of the Grayling Air Gunnery Range in northern Michigan. A-10 pilots from the 107th Fighter Squadron at Selfridge Air National Guard Base are just a 30-minute flight to the range at Grayling, where pilots face realistic and dynamic training scenarios. There, pilots are able to train with joint terminal attack controllers, placing bombs and bullets right on target.
It's an awesome target set that we can go up there and play on. They're constantly changing it around as to what their customers' needs are. Prepares you very well because you can go up there, practice it, you know, kind of training around it, and really when you start to fly over in Afghanistan, start to do the stuff that you're practicing, training for up there, you're like, oh yeah, I remember doing this up at Grayling a lot of times.
For Warthog pilots, maintainers, and their fellow airmen, ensuring this firepower is available when and where needed is at the core of their duty to their state and nation.
The thing I like the most, obviously, is serving the United States military, serving in that capacity, and helping protect the people in America overseas and being a part of that. Our biggest thing that we do as hog pilots, helping out the troops on the ground and providing that aero coverage that they could need at any time.